it's very draining if you have such a job. If you have kids, you might have both. So constantly use content posting. Well, what side is this?
What?
Yeah, probably. But I don't know what I want though, because this is not as good as it looks like. So,
ready?
It's sweet, but it's not like giving.
Okay.
She said the wild berry margarita was. Remember the other lady said it wasn't that good. It was like very sweet, but it wasn't like
strong.
Sweet and strong.
So, you got a different one from the last one?
No, it's like a chocolate. I don't see a chocolate cookie in here.
Which one did you get?
She said it's a cold of chocolate punch. I think they gave me the dos salsa margarita. Can we do, what is that one?
Quesadilla?
The chicken. How's the chicken quesadilla?
It's good.
It's pretty.
If you like spice,
uh-huh.
I still love spicy.
Okay. Oh, the hot pepper cream?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's okay.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah.
So I'll just do the chicken quesadilla.
That's good. And then, sir, what will you be having?
I'm going to do the buffalo wings, bone in. Can I get all flats if possible?
They already pre-assort our wings for 50-50 here.
Oh, okay, no problem.
And it comes with ranch or blue cheese?
Neither.
Neither? Okay, yeah. So just the buffalo sauce on them?
Yeah.
Anything else? Like a side of fries or anything like that?
Can I get a side of tater tots?
A side of tater tots?
Yeah.
Small is okay?
Yeah, it's fine. Oh. The last time we came, she had got like a green martini.
No, it wasn't green.
Or yellow.
It was like a tropical martini, but the lady who served it, she said it was like sweet but strong.
Probably our beach bum.
You think that's the one it is?
Yeah, because it comes with, it's the only martini that comes with three different types of alcohol in it, and it has like a tropical taste to it because it comes with pineapple and orange.
That's probably what it is because that sounds like, okay, can I do that?
Yeah, you want to do a peach
pie? Thank you.
Anything else I can grab you for that?
Thank you.
So what's the other question? Question number three.
That's question number two for me.
Oh yeah, question number two for you. Wow, I said three.
I shouldn't have said that.
All right. Why? We're doing question and answers.
I'm gonna get beat later.
Because every time I need to buy something.
Anyways.
Three hours later.
You got a question?
Alright.
Why do women keep the car there?
Excuse me? I'll give her 10-15 minutes. I feel like these are personal questions right now.
What, baby?
Well, we're too busy to do that, and that's not our job. That's your guys' job, to clean our car. So, do you clean my car?
Yes.
Okay, so?
If I don't, I'll get beat.
No, you don't get beat. Stop saying that. Anyways, it's not our fault. Because one day it's like really clean, and then the next day it's, I wouldn't say my car is not dirty, so. I'm not saying my car is not
dirty. No, your car don't
My
get
car
right.
is messy. So like, I'll have like a whole bunch of mail. And that's not even me. That's not even me. Anyways, so my car is not dirty as in like dirty. I can't speak for people or women whose cars are dirty because my car is messy, correct?
No, you're right, baby.
Okay.
I wasn't singling you out. I was just saying this was a question you were supposed to answer for the ladies.
Fine. Okay. So I believe that our cars are messy because we're busy. We have a busy life. We're busy trying to get ready, make it to work on time, come home, try to get to bed on time, trying to eat dinner on time, trying to eat lunch on time, trying to eat breakfast on time. We're just busy people. We're busy individuals. It's like we're always on time but late, so there's really no time to clean the car.
Good answer.
So that's why we have wonderful boyfriends like you guys.
I don't clean no cars.
To clean the car.
Yeah, I clean the car.
Yes, you clean the, you detail the car. Wax the car and all.
I don't have a choice.
But this is serious. Stop playing.
Oh, serious.
You don't get beat, so stop saying you're getting beat. It's not funny.
You want another one, babe?
I ordered it already. Thank you. For a babe, stop playing like that. Before you got people trying to call, acting like I beat you. Stop playing like that.
Who's gonna call? They're gonna be like, shit, that nigga deserve it. Whatever you did, it deserve it.
Anyways, but I don't know, it's just a hard question because I just felt like for me, I'm just always on the move, and the last thing I'm doing is really cleaning my car. But see, I'm gonna prove a point right now. When you met me, my car was always clean.
Nah, I ain't gonna lie, it was.
So now that I have someone who's cleaning my car, why should I have to clean it?
It just it was that first time of me cleaning your car, and that was it.
What do you mean?
That was it.
Yeah, it's a, you said you would clean my car for me.
Of course, I take care of everything so when it comes to the car.
So therefore, if someone tells you they're gonna clean your car for you, are you gonna clean it? No. So he cleans my car. So you need a better question than that, babe.
No, babe, because you're answering it for yourself.
Yeah. I'm answering it for myself, but before we started like really like living to each other and whatnot, I was cleaning my car. My car was always clean.
No,
I took my car to get clean every week.
And what happened?
You said you would clean my car.
I'm kidding, babe.
Anyways, I just know that for us females, it gets messy sometimes. And yeah, I clean my car every week, but my car would get a little messy. But I like smelly good things. So like, I always want my car to smell good. Like, I always want my house to smell good. I always want something to smell good. So before I met him, I used to clean my car on my own weekly until you came around and told me that I didn't have to. So maybe that's the problem. A lot of men are telling their lady they don't have to clean their car, and that's the reason why now they're dealing with messy cars.
Man, I just clean it because that's my job. I was just asking.
Yeah, so it's just messy because we know that you guys are gonna clean it. Okay. You like that answer?
Good answer.
Okay, yeah. Let's get in here. Thank you. Okay. Next question. What is your views on venting to friends about relationship issues?
What is my view on it?
Mm-hmm. On venting to your friends about relationship issues.
Well, when you mean friends, what are you saying? Like
anyone else outside of
anyone
your partner?
Anyone else outside your partner?
Friends, family, anyone outside your partner.
Well, here's the thing with that. I think you can vent with certain things, but I think certain things within your relationship should stay in your relationship. Mm. Like, you know what I mean? Certain topics should be between just those two, because everybody has their own view and their outlook, and everybody's been through their own personal things in the world. Everybody doesn't live the same 24 hours.
Right.
So someone's view on something versus, you know, they're gonna be totally different. So, I mean, with that being said, for instance, I could sit there and tell a male friend that's been dogged by females, or you know what I'm saying, like that, you know, he may agree, disagree on something I say, or you know what I'm saying, if I'm telling him something about my relationship, he may compare it to something he's been through, which is not my situation. Mm-hmm. You understand, everybody's situation is different. So with that being said, I feel like some things, yeah, if it's small, like, you know what I'm saying, because guys tell guys things and girls tell girls things. That's just how the world is. There's no, like, you know what I'm saying, in between, or it's not just shit. Niggas gossip too. That's, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, we know.
You know what I'm saying?
We know. And they gossip more than us females.
I won't say like it's more like a gossip, you know what I'm saying? It's just more like, yo, like how you, what would you do if, you know what I'm saying, your girl did this, or your, you know, your girl did this. It's not, boy, let me tell you what's going on, and you know what I'm saying? It's more just like topics, you know what I'm saying? But again, you can have a friend or a homeboy that, you know, been through some things with females, and his outlook is going to be totally different, you know what I'm saying? I may be like, yo, my girl got on my nerves today, you know what I'm saying? And it's something so little, and he be like, yeah, yo, fuck that bitch, let's go do X, Y, Z, you know what I mean? And this is an example, excuse my language, it's just an example of how it could be. And then it could be you telling your other homeboy that has a wife and kids, you know, like, yo, X-Men, he may tell you, like, yo, you wrong, you know, you need to relax, you know what I'm saying? It's not even that serious. So with that, you got to be careful, and that could be family or friends.
Right.
You know what I mean? That goes for anybody.
Right.
So you got to be really careful of, you know, the things you want to share with other people versus, you know, actually just sharing it with your partner, or, you know what I'm saying, that being disclosed between you and your partner.
I agree with you. I feel like there's certain people that you can talk to, and there's certain people that you shouldn't, like, talk about your business to, because they'll either probably try to use that against you, or try to bring it up to, like, throw, like, dirt on your relationship. And I think that goes for family too. So for instance, I feel like me, like, I'm able to, like, talk to my mom sometimes about, like, you know, certain issues that I go through, and then certain issues I don't even talk to her because I feel like, you know, she didn't go through that problem, or she can't relate to that at this very moment, so her perspective may be, like, a lot different. Just like my friends too, like, certain things I don't tell certain friends, and then certain things I learned that, like, what's the point? Like, for instance, if, like, it's like a little petty, like, disagreement, I'm not gonna go call my friend and run to my friend and be like, oh my god, I hate, you know, Brian, like, you know, I hate him, he did this, he did that. I'm not doing all of that, and I'm not gonna do that, even if, like, it's a big issue too. But I may, like, be like, oh my god, I'm overwhelmed today, I'm stressed out because, you know, he doesn't see my point of view. But I try to keep it within, like, just us. I'm not really a phone person like that. I don't really get on the phone like that. I do have certain friends that I do talk to, and when we talk, we might talk for hours, but, like, you know, I'm not on the phone like that. I'm just basically home, minding my own little business and minding my home business. But as far as talking to friends about my personal life, I learned that that's not the way to always go. Like, you have friends who care, and then you have friends who actually secretly hate you, hate your relationship. And, you know, they can't wait to see you guys separate and whatnot, so.
Yeah, I agree with that. It's a lot of miserable people. So, anybody that would want to drag you in today's space, or, you know what I mean, that's why it's important not to share every single, you know, aspect of your relationship. The only person you should really be sharing every single aspect of your relationship is your partner.
Right, because you guys are the ones that's in the relationship.
Y'all dealing with it, and everybody's situation is different, like, I just mentioned.
Yeah, everybody's, and I agree with that, because, like, there's some people actually who, they don't have any negative intentions for you and your significant other, but they don't see, or they're not in a situation like yours, so all they see, like, for instance, a guy who hates women will never see the good in another woman because they hate women. So when you talk about your girl doing one thing, or let's say, like,
it's not even a hate for women, it's the way
perceives
women in their head, you know what I'm saying?
Just like a lady who perceives men as horrible,
right,
like they're dogs, they're this and that. If I go to them and say, hey, you know, Brian got me upset today, and you know, we didn't talk for 2 hours. Maybe her first thing would be like, oh yeah, he's cheating on you. And in all actuality, he's just on the patio, and I could see him from the patio, but she would tell me something like, oh, you never know, he's cheating on you. You know what I'm saying? And this is just like, just speaking in general, because I don't have any, I don't think any of my friends ever like really dig in the relationship like that. But that's true though. It depends on where that person is, like whoever you're venting to, whoever you're talking to.
Yeah.
And whatnot.
Because again, like I said, you have friends that'll tell you, like, your friends that tell you when you're wrong are friends that's gonna give you,
your real friends.
You know, that's your real, real friends right there. Friends that could, you know, you could tell a story to, and they'd be like, well, you ain't right in this one, you know, she's right, you know what I mean? And I think we both got friends. I don't have a lot of friends, she knows that, you know, and we both don't have a lot of friends. But the friends, you know, you can, you know, confide in, you know, they tell you like, yo, you know, you're wrong, or, you know, you made a mistake, or, you know what I'm saying, something
go
like
fix
that.
It, or,
and I think it goes the same way for our parents, like her mother and my father, you know, but tell me like, nah, you wrong, you know what I mean, or you should have, you know, been clear about what a certain situation was, you know what I'm saying, instead of letting it linger, or right. You know what I mean, so.
And that's like my mom too. My mom's very fair, like my mom doesn't always, matter of fact, she never takes my side, unless, and I'm not saying like she doesn't take my side, she's very fair when it comes to anything, because she knows me as a person, and then, you know, she knows you as well. Because my mom's taking the time to, like, you know both of us, but my mom knows me too, so certain stuff that, like, he would probably be like, you know, mom, Naomi's tripping, my mom's like, yep, that's something
thank
you do.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Would you like anything else for your training?
Oh, I had a question.
Yeah, for sure.
So, did you see the...
later.
Here's a question. Do women want a man that's gonna provide or protect?
Provide or protect?
Or both. That's what I'm saying. What is in a woman's preference, basically? To provide or protect, or both?
I would say both.
I can't speak for you though, baby.
I mean, to me, like, I mean, it's a, from a woman's perspective. That's my perspective. I mean, some women want a man who's just gonna provide, because they doing whatever they doing behind closed doors. So, like we were talking about the other day, there's some women who are with men who don't live at home. They live overseas, or they don't live home. And I'm not saying that this is every woman, because there are women who are faithful that have their significant other overseas,
mm-hmm.
and whatnot, but there's women, because I've spoken to women who are okay with their man being like not being home, and they're doing them, and they're getting the money to do them. So they're going shopping, it's almost like they just want the man for financial purposes and reasons, but not really so much for, you know,
companion.
Emotional companion support or anything like that. Me personally, I want both, because I want someone who can provide for me and, you know, make sure that, you know, home is okay and we're all home safe together. Because, like, you already know, I always tell you, like, you know that I can take care of myself, you know what I'm saying, financially. So it's like, and I don't know if that, and that makes a difference too for women who can't, you know, financially take care of themselves. Maybe that's those women, but if they were able to financially take care of themselves, would they even have a man? Who knows? You know, but for me, I would want a woman, I mean, a man who would, you know, provide and protect me. You know, I'm a baby.
I know.
I told you I'm already ready to start working. I say that, but then I always want my own money and I want to do my own thing sometimes, so. But there's women who are okay with that. And there's women that are okay with the man not working and she's working, and, you know, he's making sure that there's a safe home for everyone, like, you know, providing safety at home. But to me, I would think that most women would want both. What do you think?
You know what I was raised on, baby. Both, of course. Like I said, if home ain't right, you can't be right. If you out and you got an expensive car and, you know, like, you know, you just buying shit for yourself, and your son's just walking around, and, you know, like, I wouldn't say, like, you know, messed up clothes, but messed up clothes, and your wife don't fit you, and, you know what I'm saying? That means you're not taking care of home with me, you're taking care of yourself, you know what I mean?
Yeah, because there's some people who can't afford really nice things, and that's okay.
Right.
Because, you know, as long as you take care of your household, if you can't afford, if all you can afford is Walmart stuff, that's okay, but make sure that you guys take a shower, you guys put on clean clothes, you guys...
Yeah, but if the family's wearing Walmart stuff, you should be wearing Walmart stuff as well. That's why.
Yeah, you shouldn't be wearing Gucci and Louis and all those high-end brands.
That's my whole point.
Your family is in,
like,
trash.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you're leaving your family in a predicament, basically. And, you know, I never understood or respected, you know, things like that. And I know every nigga and every female got their own, you know, thing. Everybody could be a little bit selfish. That's in human nature, you know what I'm saying? To do things for yourself and want things for yourself. That's part of daily life, you know what I mean? I don't care who fronts that and say, oh, well, you know, everything is for, and I don't ever think about, you know, myself. Everybody thinks about themselves. It's human nature, you know what I'm saying? But as far as, you know, your family and home come first, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? That's how my pops raised me. And, you know, if you don't take care of home, then everything else falls apart. And like you said, it goes either way. It's like either your whole family's wearing Gucci or your whole family's wearing Walmart. And that includes you. You know what I mean? So,
yeah.
With that being said, you know, provide and protect. You know what I mean? I'm going to make sure my family's good financially, every way wise. I want my sons looking better than me when I step out of the room. I'm content with that. I'm okay with my lady looking, you know, better than me, you know what I mean? If they good, I'm good. That's how I pretty much put it.
But you're never, like, dirty, like, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, not saying like that. Like, not saying like...
No, no, I'm just saying, like, you're never dirty.
Yeah, I'm never
gonna...
I'm always gonna match my significant other, my lady, at the end of the day. If she's clean, I'm clean. You know what I mean? That's how we are.
If I'm dirty, he's dirty. I'm just playing.
If it gotta be like that, then it gotta be like that.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you see a lot of that now. You see a nigga driving around a fly car. And this goes for females, too. This is not only just for guys, you know what I mean? And you look at home, and they got, like, 3-4 kids, and kids don't got what they need. And you know what I'm saying? Like, I just don't think there's no reason for that. If you could ball out on yourself, then you should ball out on your family. They should come first. Them looking good before you is how it should be. Like, that's always how it should be. Like I said, everybody got their selfishness with, you know, and what they want to do for themselves. But family family and home should always come first, and then everything else comes afterwards. You know,
as a man,
yeah, because that's your job, basically. There could be 2 incomes in the house, but at the end of the day, the man has to make sure, like, that everything gets taken care of at the end of the day. There may be some things, but y'all split and whatever the case may be, but if push comes to shove in certain situations, you got to be the man and say, okay, I know I got to go out there and I got to do X, Y, Z to make X, Y, Z happen. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, that's my outlook on it. I know everybody doesn't look at it like that, you know what I'm saying? But that's how I was raised. And I've been at my household since I was 17 years old. But this is what I seen my father do. He always made sure household was taken care of, like, you know what I'm saying? He didn't go get himself a Benz and everybody else was, you know, messed up or fucked up. Everybody was good, you know what I mean? So, I choose to be the same way, family. The home, household come first. Your bills, your family, your kids, and you know, your wife, that comes first.
Next question. Why do men find it hard to express their feelings to their spouse?
I think men have a... Excuse me. I think men have a hard time expressing themselves to anybody.
Oh, really?
Anybody.
And that's just anyone in general?
It's just anybody in general. It's hard to tell someone when you're struggling. It's hard to tell someone when you don't have money. It's hard to tell people a lot of things for a man because you don't want to feel less of a man. And that includes, you know, telling your kids, when you got to tell your kids, like, yo, I can't get this today, or I can't get that today, or I can't get that tomorrow, or you know what I mean? Like, that goes with everything, you know what I mean, that comes in that sequence. So I just feel like men struggle with that, and that's 95% of the men in the world struggle with that.
You're speaking for 95%.
Even telling your mom sometimes, and this is your mother, this is the person that birthed you, that's going to be the closest person to you versus your spouse. It's even hard telling them sometimes, like, yo, like, you know, this happened and, you know, this is going on. And you know what I mean? I think men actually drive themselves crazy because it's harder for them to vent in that given situation, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And this is when you're single or in a relationship. When you can't be a man and do daily things that a man do, that's bothersome for a man. And a lot of that has to do with financial issues.
Mm-hmm.
When you fucked up and it makes you feel less of a man. You know what I mean? You don't want to express that it's hard to express that to the world. Because nowadays, people make fun of you. You know what I mean? If you don't got this, you don't got this, you don't got this, you considered in a certain category, and you know what I mean?
That, and I think it's crazy. I think that situation is crazy.
That puts men in,
because,
like,
some people have, you know, all these high-end name brand, but they don't have a pot to piss in, they don't have a house, they don't have a car that's paid off. Like, so certain stuff is like...
But that's social media.
Please.
That's what social media has came and done to society. And it's not only men, it's women, it's children.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's people who really suffer because of social media. Because somebody's watching somebody else's life thinking that, yo, why is my life not like that? I'm the same age. Not knowing that all of that is just for the camera.
Mm-hmm.
The cars is not theirs, the house is not theirs, it's an Airbnb, you know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
Things like that. Like,
right.
And then there goes that person wanting to kill themselves because their life is not like that. So it's a lie. Social media has allowed us to think that that's the way you're supposed to live, when you're supposed to live within your means, whatever makes you happy, whatever's in your budget. And you know what I'm saying? A lot of people do things just because of social media. How do women feel about a man who doesn't have any ambition? What are women's thoughts on that?
No ambition?
No drive, no motor.
It's a no-go. Because what type of life are you gonna be able to give you, like your family? If she wants a family and whatnot, what type of life are you gonna give her? She's gonna be the one taking care of, like, the guy.
Do you feel like you can drive, or females can drive, a man into being successful?
Yeah, I do. I think, but he has to have something though. Like, he has to, like, you know how sometimes a guy won't do something because, you know, all he's ever heard is that he won't be nothing. He's not gonna be anything in life. He's not gonna do it. But the minute that he finds a woman who's, like, you know, motivational, like, you know, giving him a lot of motivation, inspiration, you know, just pushing him to, like, be a better person. But he should already want to be a better person, but that should just be an add to it. You know what I'm saying? Like, he can't just wake up and, like, oh, I don't care about school, I don't care about working, I don't care about providing. No, because what are you really gonna do? Because that's like you're trying to pick someone up and trying to fix them, and then you're gonna end up in a messy situation. Because what if he doesn't want to be fixed? Because why would he just wake up not wanting to do anything? Because there are people like that. There are men who don't care to do anything. They just wake up and just, yeah, like a bum. Yeah, a bum. So, like, but I do feel like when you have the proper, like, support, you can go far. Like, and that goes not only for men, that goes for, like, women, kids, everyone, like, you know, even your parents. Like, I feel like children motivate their own parents.
They do.
So it just, I think it all depends on, like, the situation. I do feel like a woman can help a man, you know, be in a better place, you know what I'm saying? But I don't think that she can make him, like, be someone that he doesn't want to be. Like, you know, if he has no motivation, he doesn't have any desires to be anything other than, like, a bum, then no, I don't even feel like she should waste her time. But there are some guys who have, like, really great ideas, they have great plans, like, you know what I'm saying, but they don't know how to go about it, and they just need, like, that extra help. That's what I always say behind every successful man is, like, you know, a successful woman. Yeah, I do feel like as long as he has some type of...
I don't think my business would have got this far without you.
Could be.
I mean, at the end of the day, like, you know, a woman keeping you structured, I think, and keeping your mind framed to where it's like, you know, you want to do it for your family, and your wife talks about doing certain things, like, you know, you want to make sure, you know, you fulfill your wife's and your kids', you know, happiness. You know what I'm saying? Our kids asked me to go to Volcano Bay for like a whole year straight, right, baby? And
they want a whole lot of things.
They
think we rich, and baby, ain't nobody rich over here.
Listen, we got two teenage boys, and, you know, they want a lot. You know, they expect a lot out of their dad and their mom, you know what I'm saying? So I was able to take them on the vacation this year from having the business and, you know what I'm saying, making money and able to do things. I'm not saying I'm rich. I'm not saying sitting here saying that, you know, we sit over here sitting on the mill, but, you know, I was able to make what they wanted come through. And without her, I can't structure myself to really, you know, do that. She makes sure I'm on point with stuff in the business, you know, when I'm, you know, slacking on something. Hey, babe, did you do this? Did you do this? Like, you know, I'm about to take a trip tomorrow to go to school. Every day since Monday, babe, did you order the film? Babe, did you book your ticket? You know what I mean? Did you do this? And I think without that, she knows me already. I would have never do it. I'd probably be booking my ticket today to leave tomorrow.
And I'm sad. I was supposed to go. But I decided not to, so that I could take care of some stuff at home. So. But you know, like, I promise, I did not remember there was no school Monday.
Me neither.
I did not remember there was no school, because if I remembered, I would have definitely went. It was just like the whole scheduling, you know, for school and everything. It was just too much to like process and like think about. I was just like, you know what? No. Babe even gave me like, what, 30 minutes to an hour. Like when he was booking the ticket, he was like, because I was like, don't worry about it, just go without me. He's like, no, you sure? And then he says, I'm just gonna wait. I'm gonna give you time to think about it, because I'm so indecisive all the time. So he's just like, I'm gonna give you some time to think about it. And then I was like, you know what? Don't even worry about it. It's a really, really short trip, so I'm just like, don't even worry about it. And now I'm sad. But yeah, I do think that, like you were saying, I do think that women can like help their men become better.
I mean, it goes either way. You either gonna push your woman to do certain things through at certain times when she's in work, and she's telling me, babe, I wanna walk out right now. And I'm like, yeah, you know, just relax and, you know, think the day, put your headphones on. But, you know, try to block everybody else, you know, out. And 90% of the time, she ends up having a good day after that. Unless there's something really, really, like, you know, bad in work to where, you know, she feels like she can't handle it. But for the most part, a pep talk right after we're done always makes it a lot better for her. She's okay with going back to work. And just like a pep talk for me, you know. I used to work for somebody that really used to get on my nerves. And if it wasn't for her, I probably wouldn't have got through a lot of those days without strangling that person, but I was able to do it. So, what, baby?
Wait, is it your turn or my turn? Did you just ask me that question?
What question, baby?
You just asked me that question.
I did?
About... Yeah, you were the one who asked me about if a man could...
Not provide.
Do you feel like if a man's not motivated for the woman?
Yeah.
All right, so the next question. How often should couples take vacations or go on dates?
It's not a date at least. A month? At least like, maybe like 3 to 5 times a month. You know what I mean? And that could consist of just going to dinner, a bar, a date, or something spectacular. You know what I mean?
Picnic.
You can mix it up. Mix and match it up, but as far as that, at least 3 to 5 times within the month. I mean, babe, we had a thing where we went out every single Friday.
Yeah, like we just started like going back out like a lot, again because we had a lot going on. But we used to literally go out every single Friday, like no matter what. We went out every single, like even if we were tired, no matter what, we got up. Even if we were dressed in like some like t-shirt and sweatpants, like we would go to like whatever restaurant. It didn't matter what restaurant. We just went to the restaurant and we just chilled out and we enjoyed our time. And then we would always feel better leaving. So we would sometimes go like just feeling like tired, like, oh, we just want to stay home and like watch a movie and order in. And then one of us would be like, nah, let's just go. And then the minute that we actually go and we get there and we start talking, it becomes like a really good night. Like, it hasn't been a night that we actually went out and we regretted it. And then when we say going out, you don't have to, like, it doesn't always have to consist of money. Like, I remember one time, we didn't go out in a little while, and one of our friends were having game night.
Yeah.
Well, my boyfriend's best friend.
Yeah.
I think it was game, no, it wasn't game night. It was a boxing match or something. And he was like, do you want to go? And he didn't even really want to go. And I was like, oh, let's just go. We haven't been out in a while. And, we had a really good time, like a really, really good time. Like, it was a really good time that we came home like, oh yeah, we weren't even gonna go, and look, we really had a good time.
Mm-hmm.
We enjoyed ourselves. So it's important to go out, because you know, when you're home all the time, you're human, it's boring staying home all the time. And we're homebodies, like we like to be, we enjoy being home. We, our home looks good, our home looks nice, we set it up to where we're comfortable, we're happy. So, and then sometimes we do get
bored.
Yeah, bored, but like I don't think we ever get tired of being home, but we do like have moments to where like we're ready to like go out.
We know we gotta step out, especially when we ain't got the kids.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
They went away on a whole summer vacation and we was acting out.
Yep. We enjoyed ourselves this summer. And it's crazy because they're like older. It's not like they're like babies, but they're not older, but they're also not babies.
Teenagers.
So, yeah, preteens.
Sorry.
But I think it's important for date night. And I know I answered this question too, but I'm speaking for the women too. And for guys, it's really important to take your girls out because, like, we like to get dressed, so we want to go out and, you know, look cute and whatnot. So, it's important.
I think that's something hard for men to understand, you know, like, you know, women wanting to get cute and go out, and it's like, you know, sometimes your man just sees you as like, babe, you beautiful, but sometimes your woman do just want to get dressed up, put something on in the closet that she hasn't worn, or, you know what I'm saying, and, you know, just go out, so just got to make it happen, fellas. I didn't even think of that. This is hard.
No, it's not.
My brain hurts.
He's unprepared. That's what I'm talking about. Like, you see how, like, I have to literally, like, tell him because he's unprepared. He knew that he was supposed to have these questions, and he's unprepared. Right, baby?
Listen, the night we were supposed to do it, I didn't tell you your allergies to stop bothering you.
Oh, yeah, so we were supposed to do this a long time ago, and he was ready, and I was... Well, he was ready, but I don't know where he put those questions at, but that was, like, 2 weeks ago. 2-3 weeks ago.
Oh, okay.
It was 2-3 weeks ago.
I know, you said 2 weeks, so it was probably, like, 3 weeks.
No, it was, like, two weeks ago. 2-3 weeks ago.
No.
All right. So, I don't know why he's unprepared, but now he's having like all these brain farts.
Would you rather be loved or feared?
Fear. No, I'm playing. What are you doing? I mean, I'm a lady. I would rather be loved. Like, what? What type of question is that?
What you mean?
What type of question is that? Sorry, we need another question.
That was a good question.
What type of question is that?
Would you rather be loved or feared?
Feared? Who's gonna fear me?
It does fear you.
So?
I say
we talking about relationship. Not
I
kidding.
Say something, nothing happens. She says something, them niggas like, jump on their toes.
No, we need a better question than that.
Yeah, baby. What's your idea of an ideal date night?
Ideal date night? Now you have me thinking, but that's not a question for every relationship. You're asking me of my ideal date night.
I know, it's in every, you're answering for every woman.
I'm not answering for every woman. Yes, some women are okay with sitting on the patio smoking a cigarette. Right?
Smoking a cigarette on the patio? He's having buzzes.
What's his name again? Country DC? Wayne? It was Country Wayne. No, it was DC.
It was DC,
not Country Wayne, yeah. DC.
That shit was funny.
Did you know your mom was settling pussy?
He said, ooh, you got that raspy voice too.
He said, auntie got that raspy voice. That's crazy.
Mm-hmm. Tell me.
3:30. Yeah.
So we get popping and head up there.
Rest in peace to DC's baby mother. Real sad situation. That was the last question? That wasn't even a question, baby. That's not a relationship question. No, it's not.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Yes, it is.
So you said, I didn't even answer the question, babe. You need a better question than that. That's not a question.
Tell me what question.
But that's not a question for relationships. That's my ideal date night. That's not everyone's ideal date night.
You're speaking for the ladies, babe.
I'm not speaking for the ladies.
Yes, you are.
Well, fine. My ideal date night is to Dubai. Dubai. Rooftop. Helicopter ride.
I'll have that, yeah.
I don't care. That's my ideal date. I'm speaking for all the ladies. All the ladies.
You gonna make all the ladies break up with their boyfriends, babe.
Okay, you have one more question for me. From me.
From me?
What do you love most about me?
What do I love most about you? Your personality.
Really?
Yes. You are the most giving person I ever met. Yeah, you know, the thing about you, babe, is like I say, you know, when you have that one friend that'll tell you like it is, but won't, you know, want to hurt your feelings, but it'll tell you like it is and be like, you know, you're wrong, or you know what I'm saying? Like, I remember numerous fights I had with, you know, my mom telling me like, babe, you know, you're wrong, you can't speak that way, or you can't do that, or, you know, no matter how much, you know, your mom, you know, hurt you or whatever, you can't you know, do that or handle the situations like that. So, and to me, I think that's, you know, dope. Personality is, you know, that's what got me actually, like, really liking it. Besides your beauty, you know what I'm saying? Really, really, like your personality, the way you see things, you know what I mean? You always look for what's right in the situation instead of, you know, what I would want to hear or what anybody would want to hear. You know what I mean? Basically, you tell people like it is, and you don't do it in a messed up manner.
I try not to. Sometimes it comes off like a little harsh, but I try not to. And when I do tell people that I love something, it's from like a really good place, like a really good place. It's almost like it's what I would want them to do for me.
Right.
So yeah. Very nice with you. Oh,
hi. What was it?